Davis to make threes. It helps their spacing. But, you know, Kentavious. Oh!
Oh, my gosh. Say it with your chest, Giannis. Put it on his head, says Wesley Matthews Jr. Wow.
Antetokounmpo has 24 points, 18 boards, and he is a terror coming at you.
The reigning league MVP, the reigning league defensive player of the year. Not only am I bringing you a Giannis Antetokounmpo build today, but I'm bringing you a legend Giannis build. This build could easily be the best big man build in NBA 2K21. Over 30 finishing badges, over 30 defensive badges. This build is absolutely insane. And if you look at it, glass cleaning finisher is the perfect way to describe Giannis's playstyle, man. But shout out to my boy Cash Out for hooking me up with this account, the legend Giannis build, man. I'm gonna leave the link to his YouTube in the description. You guys go check that out. But look at this build. 99 standing dunk, 98 driving dunk. Now, Giannis, he's not a great shooter, but he definitely should have more of a mid-range and a three ball than a 44 and a 37. So that's like the one thing that's a little bit off. But outside of that, this build is pretty much spot on. 65 ball handling, but as you guys know, in 2K21 current gen, it doesn't even matter what your ball handling is at this point because everyone can speed glitch, so everyone can speed boost. It doesn't matter. And then the defense, I mean, the perimeter defense is solid, ridiculous block and rebounding. And then look at the physicals. 89 speed on a 6'9" big. The only thing I would say is the strength obviously should be higher. That's why, you know, you see it kind of looks like anorexic Giannis. He's minimum weight. But outside of the strength being a little bit low and the shooting being a little bit low, it's literally spot on. Crazy defense, tall, max wingspan, great finishing inside. And then look at these badges, man. 35 finishing, 11 shooting, 11 playmaking, and 33 defense. That is a ridiculous badge spread. Like, that's Giannis. That is a legit Giannis type of build. And you guys know it's tough to make these superstar players in the way the builder is now. But as you can see, I mean, Hall of Fame badges like crazy. Hall of Fame Showtime is just a beautiful badge this year. Anytime you get a flashy dunk with Hall of Fame Showtime, you're going to give your teammates takeover. And then on the flip side of it, on the defensive side, we can run Hall of Fame Heart Cruiser. And basically, anytime you get a steal or a block, you're making the entire opponent's team go cold. I know we have a low strength, but we have so many defensive badges you could put on moving truck and post move lockdown to guard against post scorers. Just overall, this build is absolutely insane. So what I wanted to do was not just go to the park and just beat up on, you know, park randoms. I wanted to go to the stage and play some comp players to really show you what this build is capable of, because in my opinion, it's either this or the pure red 6'8", 6'9" build. That's the best center build. And also, by the way, not only are we a legend, but he's got unlimited boosts. Unlimited boosts, legend, Giannis Antetokounmpo build. Drop a like on the video, and let's go over to the stage and play some comp sweaty stage games. So I have three different games for you. All three I play it in a different way, okay? You can dominate in multiple ways with this build. You can be a traditional big man just setting screens, going for lobs. You can dominate defensively, and then you can even be the ball handler and basically ISO and rim run, kind of like Giannis would do in real life. But check this out, man. First game, we're playing a playmaking shot creator and a paint beast. You already know how it's going to be. Now, as I said, 65 ball handling, but it doesn't matter. Look at this. Speed glitch, tomahawk all over the paint beast. Next possessions, a little bit of the same thing. Maker's trying to cook up, throws it to me. I'm going to do a hezzy between the legs, speed glitch to the baseline, patience, pump fake, go up and throw it down. Now check this out. I catch the ball in a triple threat. The dude behind me reaches. It slides me like 3 feet forward into the paint. It's not a travel. It's not a foul. It's not anything. Maker shoots a mid-range. Can't get it to go. Our opponents get possession. So he's dancing around screens. Speed glitch. Stop, pop, pull up. Great shot. He continues to use the screen at an effective rate. Curry slide, speed glitch, snatch, hop, run, curry slide, crab, beautiful. So I see he's starting to get it going. I decide I'm going to have to sell out one of these times and try to go for a block. I'm a little late. He can't get it to go, but it gives the center inside position free board. Again, another free board. He grabs it and gets the easy two. Beautiful use of the speed glitch here to get past both of us and going for the easy lay-in. But here's where we finally get the stop that we need. He's dancing around the screen. Speed glitch again. Pulls up. Can't get it to go. Giannis is snagging. I mean, the rebounding on this build is absolutely incredible. And here we go, pick and roll. Here's where the build really separates itself. The finishing is ridiculous. He just dunks everything. Standing, driving, it does not matter. But Makri's gonna fake use the screen, get into the paint, go up and get the green lay-in. So back to our pick and roll offense. Makri comes this way. He's gonna Curry slide to the right, Curry slide to the left, pull up in the mid-range, wide open, and get it to go. So next possession, we go back to the pick and roll, but this time when Makri comes off of it, the center helps, hits me on the roll, I'm wide open, easy lay-in. When Makri comes off the screen here, he's gonna hesitate, drive to the baseline here, but the big man steps up and gets the block. So now we got to get one more stop in order to close this game out. They get that wide open alley-oop because we try to blitz the ball. And here we go, 17 to 11, easy backdoor cut. I try to get the chase down, but I can't quite get there. Next possession, he's going to speed glitch to the left, then hit a behind the back, back the other way, pull up from three, knock it down, 17, 16. He gets his takeover. And then they rush the inbounds and he steps out of bounds. So we get the ball back and Giannis is just doing Giannis type things. You want to sit in the paint? Doesn't matter that you're a pure red paint beast. We're contact dunking you. But if you thought this game was going to end without a dramatic finish, you're wrong. They get a bump steal, throw the lob. He's smart to come down with it. He's going to be patient and set up the offense. Now check it out. He's going to go behind the back, gets the crab, speed glitch to the side, pull up in the mid-range, knock it down. Game on the line. We got to get a stop. He's going to go to the Curry slide, pull up with takeover. Can't get it to go. Giannis ripping down the rebound. I'm thinking, I'm about to be real aggressive. We only need 2 points. I drive in. I'm like, you know what? Let's just reset it. You know what I mean? Let's not force it. Let's be patient. Try to get a really, really good shot. And yes, we do. Makri into the mid-range, pull up, knocks it down. So that's gameplay number one. We play as more of a traditional big man in that type of sense. 12 points, 3 rebounds. Game number 2 is when I'm going to start ISOing. So game number 2, I'm going to get to perimeter lockdown. And yes, I'm about to ISO him with my glass cleaning finisher. Okay, for most of the game, I'm ISOing this guy. So look it, go up, he gets a contest, miss, but it doesn't matter. Offensive rebound, go up, throw it down. That's a Giannis type of play. And that's what this build really is, a Giannis type build. You can catch lobs all day long. The lob catching and the finishing is ridiculous. So we're gonna ISO at times, but if they're gonna give me free lobs off the pick and roll, I'm definitely gonna use it. Draw two defenders, kick it to the corner, he's wide open, he's gonna knock that down all day. Speed glitch right past him, he's trying to spam X and steal the ball, but I'm telling you, it doesn't matter this year. Like, any build, now that we found the speed glitch, it's broken. Every build can just get to the basket whenever they want, especially a big 6'9 max wingspan, Hall of Fame finishing like this. Look at, I am killing this lockdown on a build with 65 ball handling. That's part of the problem, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not saying it's a good thing, I'm just saying, with this build, combined with the gameplay mechanics of 21, and just like that, that's a 21-0 against a perimeter lock. You see, he's got a barcode gamer tag. You guys know, those barcode gamer tags are straight sweats. That means they're boosting. They put the barcode so that they don't get banned because you don't know if it's I's or L's. That's a barcode lockdown getting cooked by my Giannis build. On to game number 3. Game number 3, and we're taking on Flu and Hundo, two very well-known players in the community, good players. They play the stage, you know, they're very good 2v2 players. So here we go, 2v2, Flu and Hundo versus Makri and Joe Knows. Right off the rip, Makri's wide open in the corner off my drive, and I'm going to hit him. You know, Giannis draws attention, and Giannis also sells the bag right here because I give them the ball back. But here we go. Flu's wide open. Of course, he's going to knock that down all day. So 3-3. Next possession, Flu drives baseline, runs all the way through. I drop back onto Hundo, but they're still able to get the tip-in alley-oop. But what I really love about this build is the speed. For a big man to have 89 speed and the way the gameplay is in 2K21, being able to hedge the right side, left side, step up, get back, and still get the rebound or get the contest is such a valuable thing for the big man this year. And this build having 89 speed, it really helps on defense and on offense. I mean, you can get in position to get alley-oops. You can, you know, like I said, you can ISO and cook a lockdown. This year on current gen 2K21, having speed on a big man build is very, very important because the only time strength really matters is in the post. So if you're not a post scorer, it's much more valuable this year to have 90 speed than it is to have 90 strength on your big man build. That's what you see a lot of people doing. A lot of people are having, you know, these 40, 50 strength centers because, listen, unless you're facing a post score, there's really no point to have strength in this game. It doesn't really help with rebounding. Doesn't really help with, you know, defense besides post defense. I mean, look, we got a 50 strength and we're still bodying Hundo. This build is just incredible. It's a really good Giannis build. If it had a little bit better shooting, you know, if you put the mid-range and the three-pointer up a little bit, it would really be the perfect Giannis build for 2K21. But even without the shooting, I mean, you still play just like Giannis. You're grabbing rebounds, you're finishing everything inside, your defense is incredible. You You know, with the wingspan and the height and the speed and the athleticism, you cover so much ground defensively, which is, you know, one of the main reasons Giannis won Defensive Player of the Year. The dude can do everything defensively. And on top of it, you're grabbing every rebound, you're dunking everything, you're posterizing people, you're finishing everything in the paint. It's really just the perfect Giannis Antetokounmpo build, man. So hopefully y'all enjoyed these three sweaty. I usually don't do these sweaty type of gameplays, but hopefully y'all enjoyed them, man. Something a little different here to end off current gen 2K21 legend Giannis build. Let me know what y'all think. If you haven't already, make sure y'all drop a like for me. Subscribe if you guys are new. I'll catch y'all in the next video. I'm out. Peace.